very quickly what the Lord has put on my heart. To all the youth, to all the church, I want to encourage you, because I'll tell you what. This young man, this teenager at this time, Samuel, stood before God. Okay, he stood before God. And I want to share 4 points that he did. Very quickly. Before I get into it, I need to paint the picture. And I like to do that because you need to understand what is taking place at this point in time. And what takes place is this man, okay, of God, Samuel, is born in the culture where the high priest is corrupt. The high priest does not sense and have a presence with God. His sons are living in sexual immorality with the servants of the Lord's house. They're stealing from the sacrifices of the Lord. He's living in a perverse culture where the Bible says the word of God was rare. The word of God was rare. And so it's important for us to understand that in this situation where the word of God was rare, he was a man of God, that God in his timing opened this door for Samuel. And this first point is, be in the place God calls you to be. Be in the place that God calls you to be. If God has called you to be in a certain place, you need to be in that place. Do not walk away. We see that Samuel, this young man, as he was brought from the beginning, okay, into God's house through his mother, as dedicated to the Lord. From a young child, he was where he was meant to be. And he could have said, no, this is not my calling. But no, he stayed where he was put. And sometimes you come to church and you're thinking, what's the point of it? What's the point of me coming to church? You know, I've heard the same old message. I've, you know, been doing this tradition thing for so long. There is a point. Because there will come a time and you'll see what something will happen to you. Now, it's interesting because the time that he lived in, you would expect that he would know God, or have at least a closer relationship with God. But when you look at the leadership of that time, Eli, okay? The Bible says when Hannah came before him and she was praying to God, but not saying words, what did he say? Woman, you're drunk. Sober up. What do you mean? Instead of being sensitive to the leading of the Holy Spirit to understand what was happening, he accused her of something that she wasn't. And so it's important for us to understand that he grew up in this culture. He grew up in this culture. Even if you live in a culture and the environments around you may be quite difficult, stay where you are meant to stay, because it's very, very important. And even in difficult times, God will show up, okay? Not when you say, but when he says. It's on God's clock. It's on God's clock, and we need to understand that. Number two, doing your part. We see through the word of God, as is mentioned in 1 Samuel 2:26, that child Samuel went on growing both in stature, in other words, in physical appearance, and in goodness. He was pleasing before men, and also it says before God, before Jehovah, before the Lord. And so he was doing his part. And sometimes you may come to church and say, oh, why do we have to sing? Why do we have to do these things? Why do we have to praise the Lord? And until you meet your God, your Creator, if you have not met with him, stay on course and say, Lord, even if I don't know, look, I want to know you, but Lord, I want to serve you. And so it's very important to understand this principle, even though the Bible makes it clear he did not know the Lord, he served before the Lord. He served before the Lord. Some of yous out there, you serve God, but maybe you don't have a personal relationship with him. And it's important for you to understand that there is a calling in this evening. And so you need to do your part. Stay, first of all, in the position God called you to. Secondly, is doing your part. Serve God. Do it with whatever you have, whatever God's given you, until the point that he reveals himself. The third part, and I'm going to get to, is the call of the Lord. And this is one of the most interesting things because, you know, this man did not know God. He did not know God, but yet he served God, okay? But God in his time, he will call you. In God's perfect time, he will call you and he will reveal himself to you. And you know what? He will call you to get away from this sinful world. He will call you and say, you need to serve me. You need to do what I called you, what I've asked you to do. And perhaps the Lord is asking you tonight. Perhaps the Lord is asking us tonight to say, you need to get back into serving me. You need to get back into having a passion and a desire to serve me. Or you need to come from your life of sin into a life of forgiveness and fellowship with me. And so you know, we don't understand exactly where we might be, but hopefully the Lord can reveal to us. As I look again to Samuel, straight away, when the Lord spoke to him, he did not know. And so many times where you can be in the house of God and God can be speaking to you and you do not even know. Maybe you think it was a nice song. Oh, it was a beautiful sermon. Oh, I felt tingly in the heart. But it's God speaking to your heart. It's the Holy Spirit that absolutely goes straight through to the heart to convict. And it's very important for us to understand. And as this young Samuel did not know the voice of God, the Bible says when the Lord called him, he ran to Eli. And so he was a very obedient young man. Even in not knowing God, he was still obedient. He ran to Eli. He says, "Did you call me?" "No, go back to sleep." Now this happens again. And it's important for us to understand that he was obedient straight away. I mean, Eli was his master. He was his teacher. So he went back to him straight away. Important how we react. And this call on our lives is really this. The Lord Jesus wants, first of all, if we are not right with him, if we do not have a personal relationship with him, number one, we need to acknowledge our sin and come before him with all our heart, with all our strength, with everything. And secondly, once we have committed ourselves to God, is to serve him. And this is what the call of God is upon our lives tonight. And you know what? God is persistent. God doesn't just stop after one time saying, "Samuel." Look, he didn't listen. God persists until you listen. And you know what? For some of you, it may take 10 years, 50 years, but the voice of God still speaks. Hopefully, he still speaks. But it's very important for us to hear the voice of God. And the voice of God cried out to Samuel in this time, 3 times. But the word of the Lord says in verse 7, he did not know him. He did not know him. And so Eli being a man of God, told him, respond. And he told him how to respond. And I'm thinking in my mind, how can he not know God, right? He's worshipping, he's serving before the temple. He knew God as the God of Israel, the one true God, the spiritual knowledge of him perhaps he had. He knew the ways of the Word of God. He knew how to worship, or say how he thought, the ways, the ordinances. He knew all these things. However, he didn't know the God of the Bible. He just knew about God. And so the Lord revealed himself to him. Eli tells him and he says, "Speak, Lord." This is what his answer is. "Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening." Very interestingly, he says, "Speak, Lord," tells this to Samuel, "for your servant is listening." Now, how does he say this? He misses out one word. He says, "Speak, for your servant is listening." I see this young man who doesn't know the Lord as his Lord. I see this young man who is humble and wants to know, but at the end of the day, he hasn't made a decision that he's the Lord as yet, but he wants to. And we'll see his heart change. And there's these 3 elements that we need to look at. The first one is this. It says, speak. His desire to hear of God. What is your desire in this evening? What is your desire in this evening? Do you want to hear of God? Do you want to hear of things that tickle our ears? Do you want to hear something that is interesting? Or do you want to hear the word of God that you need Jesus in your life, that you need a fresh anointing of the Spirit in your life, that you need to awaken from your situation, as Brother Sergio spoke about, that we need to have this desire for the Lord? And secondly, as he said, "Speak, Lord," in other words, "Lord, I want you to speak." The second point, he says, I'm your servant. In other words, I will humble myself. I will do what is required to serve you, Lord. And then the third component is listening. Okay? Not just listening. Like some of you may be listening, but I don't know how much is registering. And I pray the Lord that you are this registering. Because it's very important that when we hear the word of God, the Bible says that we be hearers and doers of the word. Not just hearers, not just listening to the word of God. So there's these 3 elements. Okay? Now, this man is a young teenager, okay? He's a young teenager that the Lord reveals himself. And the Lord reveals something very, very sensitive. A prophecy. And says all these things. Bang, bang, bang. Lists them up about the house of Eli and what he's done wrong and all these things as he's listed up. And so I'm imagining this teenager, probably about, you know, 12 to 17, maybe 18 years of age, going, wow, I'm supposed to tell the high priest this? This is crazy. You know, this is pretty much, I'm telling him, God is going to finish with you and judgment is coming upon your household. You are finished. Wow. That is almost crazy for us to imagine. And yet, the Bible says he was afraid. He was afraid. Nevertheless, even in his state, even in his state of being afraid, even when Eli says to him, and this is quite interesting, he says, God do so to you and more if you don't tell me. In other words, he's cursing him. Dacă nu-mi spui, Domnul să facă și mai mult. As in, towards you, in a negative sense. In other words, he threatened him. You need to tell me. And so we see this man of God cursing him. So ironic. But I don't know if you read a chapter before or if you've read this story. In the chapter before, it says that a man of God already revealed to Eli this punishment. Samuel was the confirmation. So that's why when he heard this word, he received it. He received it. And so it's very important that when God, through the Holy Spirit, sends a certain word, it's important for us to understand what actually takes place. And as a result, I'm going to move, and this is the final point, very, very important, is this result. Because this is the crucial part. Because we can do our part, we can stay where we are, we can listen to the voice of God, we can hear it and obey it. But it's also what happens after. The Word of God says Samuel grew, he developed. You know, he went from, you know, in his physical development to his mind, to his knowledge, to the relationship and honor, as the Word says through this word or the meaning of it. In chapter 3:19 says, Samuel grew and the Lord was with him and let none of his words fail or fall to the ground. Verse 21, the Lord appeared again in Shiloh, for the Lord revealed himself to Samuel, again in Shiloh, by the word of the Lord. So, in sum, more importantly, is that the Lord is with you. As a result, when the Lord calls you, he wants to be with you. He doesn't want you to be by yourself. He doesn't want you to be struggling in your life of sin and going, gee, what do I do next? He wants to be in and next to you and close to you at every step of your life. As Brother Sergio said, there is a narrow way. Very, very narrow way in which, you know, we can't do on our own strength. If I try, I will fail. But only with the Holy Spirit's help in my life that I can go through this way. And the presence of God is what is more important than anything else in your life. It's more important than anything else in your life. And it's important for us to understand. The presence is very important. But secondly, to also concrete what the presence of God is doing in your life, there is evidence. Amen? Amen. There is evidence, and we see that as is mentioned here, that none of his words failed. It wasn't Samuel's words, it was the Lord's words. And so when the Lord speaks, when the Lord does something in your life and tells you to do a certain thing, it's from the Lord. It's not your own word. And make sure it's from the Lord. And there is evidence. And the last one, and I love the, you know, this in this three section of this result, is the Lord appeared. You know, God is interested in a relationship with you tonight. He's so interested and he doesn't care so much about, you know, other things apart from knowing you. The Bible says, for God so loved the world. You know, God just didn't love the world. He so loved it. There is so much love that God's revealed. And at the same time, if we don't respond, there is that wrath. You know, we can't preach love without preaching wrath. We've got to be equal. So if we don't respond to this love of God, the wrath of God awaits. I don't know about you, but I'd rather take the grace of God and receive the Lord than wait for his wrath on that final judgment day. And I pray the Lord to be a reality. We want to sing a song. I'm going to invite a group to sing the next song. There is one more song that we want to sing, and I pray the Lord to give you patience. It's called Noi Te Așteptăm. Lord, we wait for you. I really want us to come before God in this evening as we close. If we can stand to our